Hello again, my friends, Metal Chef Mad Max. We're going to do some more marinating of meats.
And another victim today is this beautiful halal chicken. I prefer to buy my chicken in the Middle Eastern stores because it's less fatty. And it's halal, that means, you know, it's clean and deal with the very... very cleanly, and it's not full of junk some places they do. Okay, the marinade. I do a marinade chicken. I make this pico de gallo, and some people, they really love it. My dear friend Laura Oliver, she dig it. She tear that head shit up. My Asunta friend from Cantoros, it was not sure about it, and so I got it for a couple days in the fridge, still good, not spoil or anything. I decided to put it in a blender and make some cool marinade with it. So this goes in my torture machine. A handful of cilantro, then two jalapenos, no, not two, one jalapeno sliced in half. I removed the seeds and ribs, so I'm not really looking for very spicy deal with that, because I'm cooking for the princess, my daughter Michelle, and goes to the pot. And a little bit of oil blend, and because it's going to be a marinade, so we have to season up the chicken in this particular occasion. A little bit kosher salt, and what else I can add? I want some little bit kind of unusual flavor, so I'm adding to the blender two old spice. Who the hell taking pictures? The ghost? No, man, no. No more taking blank pictures of the table. No, dude. And it's my Uncle Henry, I think. Come to visit me. Love you, Henry. So let's go do this thing. We got my ingredients in the machine. And we're gonna do some chopping by machine. Jalapeno juice in my eyes, but that's my fault. I shouldn't look inside. Don't do this at home. Kitties, adults, nobody. I'm just crazy son of a pop, so I do stuff like that. I'll tell you the story. One time I was trying to clean a stove, and I mix a couple things and almost get myself to La La Land, but that's a different story. Again, my delicious garlic shallot sauce you can use for all kinds of, you know, eating. I use for marinating too. I will add 2 spoons of my garlicky goodness to the whole deal. And so we got going, you know, 2 different cooking cultures. We got Middle Eastern Arabic with the garlic, you know, sauce, and we got Latino with the pico de gallo salsa deal. So it's nice and chopped up. This tastes like a shit, man. I couldn't believe you. Alright, a little bit more salt. It's not spicy at all, so I'll add a little bit habanero sauce in it. Shit, I don't want to put that in my eyes. That will be the fiasco. And acidity, it's not there. So again, mingling with the cultures. I'm adding a little bit rice vinegar. And see what's happened with that. I'm forgetting the really cool paprika from Hungary. It's this one, it's sweet, it's not smoke, not spicy, just adding really nice flavor and really nice color to your food. Beautifully bright. Alright, no double dipping again. New spoon. Much better. Much better, but still I'm missing something, man. Still not spicy. So a little bit of my little friend Melinda's. This company make really cool hot sauces. Very spicy or milder. And how we're gonna deal with this? I washed the chicken, it's nice and clean. How we gonna deal with this victim? I'm gonna dump him right here and split it in the middle through the breastbone. My knife getting dull, so I'll get my friend from Germany. And I split it only breastbone. Then I'm gonna break it up like people got break it on the wheel back in the day. And use this little bucket because we're gonna refrigerate it. And make it happen maybe for a day or two. So that's the marinade. It's pretty tasty. A little bit in the bottom. And we're gonna give a bath to the little friend. Flipping around, pour some marinade all over. Pour some sugar on me. And that was, I break it down with a little bit of the flapper. So you rub it. Again, massaging the meat. What? Massaging the meat. Oh, okay, okay. I have to keep it children friendly. Pardon me, I'm not gonna follow anymore. And you know, put it under the skin. You under my skin. That was Frank Sinatra, man. I'm jumping from the song to song, man. But you know, that's who I am. Rock and rolling, Wild Mad Max. Okay, then you have it. Deliciously marinated garlic. Peter Cotigallo marinate with the fresh cilantro and a little bit touch of the rice vinegar. It's gonna sit there for a day or two in the fridge doing a thing, and then we're gonna see what's happened. Maybe I'll grill it, maybe I'll roast it, maybe I'll toast it, maybe I'll stick it in a I don't know why I'm getting all hyped up thinking about it. Okay, keep on cooking, keep on rock and rolling. Love you people. Booyah.